And was it Justified News?
Oh, yeah.
Submitted by Vancouver Loves JK Crew.
Oh, Van Calver.
A woman admits to killing and burying her father after finding his stash of child porn images. Oh, it's great. A fun one.
Justified.
Fun one.
Justified.
You can make it fun.
We're going to make it fun.
Yeah. A daughter kills her father.
He raised a good daughter.
That's what I'm saying. But what if it wasn't even his?
How much you want to bet the father told her to kill him?
Oh. How much you want to bet?
Like, I'm an evil man. I'll bet $1 million because there's no way you could prove it.
Why can't I? What do you mean?
Or disprove it.
If it's in the article, then you're going to owe her $1 million.
Unless there's a written note that says, I did not convince my daughter to kill
you. Just get the fuck out of here. How about that?
All right.
Guess you don't have any friends in this room, David.
I do.
Thanks for being on my side, friend.
I didn't mean to. I really didn't mean to.
So.
Wow.
I got David's back.
Is there child porn, like, magazine?
What?
Did he have a stash of magazines and like...
Oh yeah, is there like a publication?
Like Playboy, but like...
Like Play Kids.
Yeah.
Fuck, dude.
Oh, wow.
I'm out.
I fucking hope not. Why do you giggle? Why do you giggle? Why is that funny?
That's so funny.
Play Kids.
How do you have green shit in your teeth still?
What I'm curious,
what I can say.
Cause it's his stash, right? Well, it could be, it could be downloaded files, but then, you know, but I'm just wondering, okay?
Pictures.
So I'm gonna go into uncharted territory, and this is not a joke. This is pure curiosity, okay? So, like, whenever we hear the word, like, child porn or whatever, right? It's usually video format or downloaded, whatever. But
pictures.
Yeah, but did they ever have a publication for it, or did they ever have some underground?
You know what I've
That's
heard?
True.
There might be some stuff because I have heard. Oh, we did it here where an actor was caught with child porn, and then he had on his computer he had instructions about how to.
Oh, Jared. Subway dude.
No, it was another.
It was like Mark Salling, right?
Something like that. Yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And there was like an instruction manual on how to prep like infants or something, or like toddlers to begin doing shit to them.
I get Joel's question, because back in our high school days, weed was like heroin, right? Like it was crazy illegal.
Literally, it was classified.
Yeah, like you don't want to fuck with that shit because cops will beat your ass if they catch a dub sack on you, right? But even with that, there was High Times. And High Times operated, it was a publication. You can't get it at Barnes & Noble, but that publication existed. So I think what Joe is asking, as illegal and as heinous as this shit is there a publication?
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'm almost 1,000% sure you can't have a publication about that.
Like a dark web type of shit? There are probably websites where...
Yeah, there's websites everywhere.
But I guess he's talking about physical, like High Times physical copy.
Yeah, for the older generation.
Yeah.
I feel like wasn't there like a manual for fucking mail order brides and shit? Did I make that up?
I don't know.
Well, mail order brides aren't illegal.
They're not illegal.
And they're pretty great.
They come in a box, they unfold themselves, it's fantastic. You just gotta give them a couple of hours to inflate.
Hours to inflate, goddamn. Yeah.
And they speak Filipino, Tagalog and shit.
All right, so this happened back in 2006. Barbara was 51 years old when she
found-
Her name
is Barbara? That's tight.
When Barbara was 51 years old, she attacked her 87-year-old father.
That's a 51-year-old name.
Barbara?
Yeah, it's appropriate.
That's true. I don't know any young Barbaras.
None.
I do. I went to high school with a Barbara.
I know.
Does she look old as fuck?
No.
Yeah.
That's actually.
There you go.
Does your Barbara look fucking old or whack?
No.
Barbara sounds like a 40 plus.
They call her Barbie.
Yeah, mine too.
When was the last time you had a Martha?
My mom.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
There you go. It makes sense.
No, that's like 50 plus.
My sister.
No, that's 60 plus.
That's the name of my street.
All right. Go to Martha Street, y'all.
Did you ever see a picture of Martha Washington? I'm like.
You should tell him that is.
So I'm like, George Washington was fucking gay, dude. She looks like a dude, just a straight up dude. She looks like Benjamin Franklin.
Now you're just offending all the.
You probably had a crush.
All those old photos of ladies, I'm like, man, that was rough.
I'm like, everyone was gay back then.
Even the hottest girls were like.
But I'm sure those era people are looking at, if they could, look at our generation now and they're like, what the fuck? Are they all synthetic?
I know, because I go, girls are getting hotter and hotter.
That's damn straight.
And there's more beautiful people happening every year.
All right, so this is Barbara.
Oh.
She's now 63.
Good job. You should get a trophy.
Yeah, she
should. So what she did-
Or we'll hear the whole story before we jump.
Her dad had her dig up some hole in the back garden, And then that's when she came across this box filled with sexual photographs of children in the dining room.
And it was her as a kid.
They don't mention
in it. His dining room?
In his dining room.
Holy shit, so he was fucking doing it?
Like taking the pictures.
I don't know if he was taking the photos.
Oh, they found him in the dining room.
They found these photos in the dining room.
Oh no, I guess the question is, are the pictures of the kid inside his dining room?
They found these photos in the dining room.
No, because I was on the same page as Joe. I was like, oh fuck, they used the dining room as a location for the shoot. I'm like, that's fucking crazy.
Or you know what, you could be right. This is what it says. After finding a box of sexual photographs of children in the dining room of his home.
Yes.
Oh yeah, that's literally it.
After finding a box. Maybe, I don't know, yeah, I don't know.
No, it sounds like they found him in the dining room.
Okay, so they found him in the dining room. Okay, the dining room's not in the pictures.
Can you guys write better articles, please?
That's what it says, so I don't know how to interpret it.
Not everyone's a movie writer, you know what I'm saying?
All right, so she ended up...
a movie that's never gonna be made, but keep going.
It will fucking get.
I know it will.
You can't say it hasn't been made in 4 months.
I don't even know what the fuck you guys are talking about. You guys are having an inside conversation.
You guys are such crazy YouTube people. They think you write a movie script and it instantly gets made. Fucking YouTubers, man. Drive me crazy.
You know what it is? It's because it took them 6 years to write it. That's why. So technically, it's been 6 years and 4 months.
Not really. Once I jumped in, man, they had it was nowhere. Nowheresville.
Okay.
So she found the box.
So Barbara went up to, since she was using a shovel to dig up these holes, right?
Yeah.
She grabbed the shovel, hit her dad over the head.
Oh fuck! She didn't even think about it.
She didn't even question him. Like
that's the way they're writing this.
Damn.
I'm pretty sure there was some dialogue.
She's like, "What is that? I have a problem. I need help. Help, motherfucker! Bam! I help you go to hell."
I hope you go to hell is dope.
That's a dope movie.
That's a dope movie name.
I need help. You know how people always say that as a fucking cop out or like in 20, you know, 2020 Chris Hansen shit? Like the fucking Catch a Predator? I need help. I got problems. Oh yeah, you need help.
Yeah.
Go to hell.
To Catch a Predator is amazing.
It's incredible.
And I just started watching the old episodes on YouTube again recently.
Same.
This is one episode where this guy cracked me up because he comes in and Chris Hansen comes out, he goes.
I know I have a problem, sir. He's like, why are you hiding your face? I'm not supposed to be here. The whole time he's like this. It's like, bro, they already saw you the whole time.
I love the guys who, it's like, did you know how old she was? And he's like, and he's like making it up. He's like, I think 13. And it's like, oh man, dude.
That makes it better than 11.
Yeah, it's so good.
It's like, 14 and a half.
There's an episode where you see Chris Hansen irritated at a guy because he came in and it was the same guy he saw last week that he just got caught. And Chris Hansen was like,
I saw that one.
I just saw you last week.
Wait, then why did they release him?
No, because that was when they were doing it where they didn't give him to the sheriff yet.
Yeah.
Like it was in the early days, it just exposed them.
Yeah.
But then later in the they had the because of the same people who you are wrote letters like, what the fuck, why aren't you in
prison? Good, they should be writing those letters. Yeah. All right, back to this story though. So she ended up hitting the dad with the shovel. When he turned around, she sliced his throat with the edge of the shovel.
Whoa, movie!
Wow. Yeah.
He was there bleeding.
That's precise.
And then while he was bleeding to death, she wrapped his body in an old carpet. And then the next day, she ordered a ton of soil to be, and then she buried her dad in the garden next to a tree.
Damn.
Whoa, she got caught?
So she was collecting his pension this whole time. And so she successfully lied to the father's doctors and then family around and then the benefit advisors and told them that she told family and friends that the dad died in the hospital and that he was just cremated. I'm not sure what lies she told to the hospital doctors or anything, but she ended up duping him this whole time until finally there was someone from the benefits place that went to go, they wanted to speak to the man face to face, like they didn't want to deal with the daughter. And then that's when she just went to the police station and admitted to killing her father.
How many years did she get away with it?
This was back in 2006.
Okay. Oh, so recently she
12
came
years.
Out.
Are they gonna get her, man? Are they gonna get her? Cause I don't want them to get her.
I feel like it might not be true. Did she save the box of photos to show to the cops?
I don't know.
Because here's the thing. A lot of people do kill their parents to collect a pension. Yeah. That's the sad truth.
Damn, that sucks.
Well, apparently this man was a very, like a formidable ex-military man. And so he would be abusive to her, but yeah, you're right, this could be coming just-
It could just be like, you know, she never had love back for him and a lot of resentment, like, fuck you, dad, you fucking beat me up or whatever.
Because there needs to be that stash of child porn for proof, because then she's just like saying crazy shit.
Then she was holding on to child porn for years herself.
True.
The fuck?
Yeah, why would she hold on to it?
Yeah, but that's like-
I would bury it with him.
That's what I would do.
Yeah. And I put another note, this motherfucker dead because of this reason.
I would put, this is not my child porn. Dash Steve.
Yep.
See?
And then a fingerprint.
And then you would spray your cum all over it, just in case.
Just in case. Then you need to identify myself.
Oh no.
And I'd be like, I can explain.